Thank you. St. Barnabas and St. Lambert. It is so nice to be here with you all on this warm, beautiful day. And today's theme is to ask, to search, and to knock. And that relates to prayer. That when we are in need, when we are in sorrow, when we are in happiness, when we are in celebration, we call upon the Lord and we ask, and indeed we do receive. And today we will be receiving, through baptism, Emmy Faye Harlan. And all the Harlan clan is here today. Wow, look at that. And you're all welcome back next Sunday, too. And everybody said amen on this time. Anyway, it is indeed great to see all of you here. Welcome. And I'm sure that when Emmy's splashing about in the water, you'll all want to come up and get baptized. But in the meantime, we have a service, and our service begins with our opening hymn, I Sought the Lord, hymn number 547. Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated for today's reading.
A reading from Amos 9:11-15, the restoration of David's kingdom. On that day, I will raise up both David's that is fallen and repair the breach. Raise up its ruins and rebuild it as the day of old, in order that they may possess the remnant of Edom and all the nations who are called by my name. Say that the Lord who does this, the time is surely coming, says the Lord, when the one who will plot shall overtake the one who reaps, and the traitor of the grapes, the one who sows the seeds. The mountains shall drip sweet wine, and all the hills shall flow with it. I'll restore the fortunes of my people Israel, and they shall rebuild the ruined cities and inhabit them. They shall plant vineyards and drink their wine, and they shall make gardens and eat their fruit. I will plant them upon their land, and they shall never again be plucked up and out of that land. And that I have given them, says the Lord your God. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
Thanks be to God. Our song this morning is from 85. Lord, you were favorable to your land. You restored the fortunes of Jacob.
You forgave the iniquities of your people. You pardoned all of our sins. You withdrew all your wrath. You turned from your thought anger. Restore us again, O God, for the sake of our sins. And put away your iniquities before your brothers.
Will you be angry with us forever? Will you prolong your anger to all generations?
Will you not abide by our shame, so that your people may rejoice with you?
Show us your steadfast love, O Lord, and grant us your salvation.
Let us hear when the Lord God the Lord will speak, for he will speak.
Surely his salvation is at hand for those who fear him, that his glory may dwell in our land. Faithfulness will spring up from the ground, and righteousness will look down from the sky. Righteousness will go before him, and will make a path for his steps.
A reading from Colossians. As you therefore have received Christ Jesus the Lord, continue to live your lives in him, rooted and built up in him, and established in the faith, just as you were taught, abounding in thanksgiving. See to it that no one takes you captive through philosophy and empty deceit, according to human traditions, according to the elemental spirits of the universe, and not according to Christ. For in him, the whole fullness of deity dwells bodily. And you have come to fullness in him, who is the head of every ruler and authority. In him also, you were circumcised with a spiritual circumcision, by putting off the body of the flesh in circumcision of Christ, when you were buried in him in baptism. You are also raised with him through faith in the power of God, who raised him from the dead. And when you were dead in trespasses and the uncircumcision of your flesh, God made you alive together with him, when he forgave us all of our trespasses, erasing the record that stood against us with its legal demands. He set this aside, nailing it to the cross. He disarmed the rulers and authorities, and made a public example of them, triumphing over them in it. Therefore, do not let anyone condemn you in matters of food and drink, or of observing festivals, new moons, or Sabbaths. These are only a shadow of what is to come, but the substance belongs to Christ. Do not let anyone disqualify you, insisting on self-abasement and worship of angels, dwellings on visions, popped up without cause by a human way of thinking, and not living fast to the head, from whom the whole body, nourished and held together by its ligaments and sinews, grows with the growth that is from God. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
Thank you.
Thank you. the Lord Jesus Christ.
He was praying in a certain place, and after he had finished, one of his disciples said to him, "Lord, teach us to pray as John taught his disciples." He said to them, "When you pray, say, Father, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, for we ourselves forgive everyone indebted to us. And do not bring us to the time of trial." And he said to them, "Suppose one of you has a friend, and you go to him at midnight to say to him, 'Friend, lend me 3 loaves of bread, for a friend of mine has arrived, and I have nothing to set before him.' And he answers from within, 'Do not bother me. The door has already been locked, and my children are with me in bed. I cannot get up and give you anything.' I tell you, even though he will not get up and give him anything, because he is his friend, at least because of his persistence, he will get up and give him whatever he needs. So I say to you, ask, and it will be given to you. Search, and you will find. Knock, and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and everyone who searches finds, and for everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. Is there anyone among you who, if your child asks for a fish, will give a snake instead of a fish? Or if a child asks for an egg, will give a scorpion? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him?" The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
I worked up through sales management. I became
vice president, and I never had to lose the knack of asking, searching, and knocking. I was on commission. If I didn't ask, I didn't search, and I didn't knock on doors, I didn't eat. If you had seen me back in the 80s, you would realize that I ate very well. It was difficult, though, because we lose confidence in ourselves, we lose confidence in sometimes our product, we lose confidence in life. But Jesus is clear. He's saying, ask, search, and knock, because those who ask it will be given to you, those who search you will find it, and the doors will be open to those who knock. And I realized that there were times when I would knock on doors that they would be opened immediately. And sometimes I could hear the mutter from the office in the back, get rid of that guy, I don't have time for him today. And I said, oh yeah, I'll show you. They often became our best customers. But what about our prayer life? This whole topic today is about prayer. Jesus Christ is with his disciples, he's been praying, and one of them, there's always one of us, goes to Jesus and says, could you teach us, not only himself, but all of the disciples, how to pray, perhaps the way John the Baptist was teaching his disciples. And Jesus simplifies it. So often in life, whatever we ask becomes very difficult and complicated, but prayer is simple. And Jesus tells them, when you pray, simply say, Father, Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come. In other words, your Holy Spirit come upon us and cleanse us, so that your will be done on earth as in heaven. In other words, in the kingdom of God. And give us each day our daily bread, not only for today, but for tomorrow, to fulfill our needs and our wants. Sometimes, whatever that is, if it's within the will of God. I often reflect on my time as a salesman when I would be rushing up to see a client and I would be just on time. But there was no place to park. And I'd been driving around and around and around, and something would come to me and say, just ask the Lord. Lord, find me a place to park. And lo and behold, the seas would open up in front of me and there would be a great place to park. Some of you are nodding, you've done the same thing. Can the Lord not give us some simple things as a place to park when you're anxious and worried about putting bread on your own table? The Lord does indeed give us the desires of our heart, but our hearts need to be in sync and in line with what God wants for us. It goes on to say, if your child asks for a fish, will you give them a snake? In some of our scriptures it says, if a father is asked of a child for a fish, will the father give them a snake? If he asks for bread, will he give him a stone? If he asks for egg, will he give him a scorpion? All the fathers here today, what would you do? I'm looking at your children right now, I don't think they go without. And that example is the same of our Heavenly Father, that his children do not go without. Because I'm sure that if the fathers did not give the bread and the fish and all the needs of the child, the mother certainly would. And the father would pay for it, wouldn't they? Simple. But prayer is simple. If we allow our hearts to be in sync with what God wants for us, he provides everything for us. It even goes on to say, if you then who are evil know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask? Now some of you say, but I am not evil. But if we understand the meaning of this word evil, it's not that you or we are evil, but it's because we are in an evil state of the turmoil and the toil that we have been placed under. Jesus is speaking to people who have become servants and slaves. They are under great toil. They are under the evil of other people. And yet even under that bondage, they know how to give to their children. And the Heavenly Father knows how to give to the children as well. But all of us need to come under this power of the Holy Spirit. And this Holy Spirit is promised to us through our baptism.
today we are having a baptism. And in 2 weeks, we're going to have another baptism. Water's going to be everywhere. But we need to put off the body of the flesh. And this reading was quite spectacular. And it speaks of the body of the flesh, rather, it calls us to be in the body of the Spirit, that we have been buried in baptism. In other words, our old body has died and been buried, and we've been renewed and brought up in the waters of baptism. Just as Jesus Christ, when he went down, and then when he came back up, he was a new person and alive. And as we baptize little Emmy today, although we won't be dunking her, we will be spreading the water on her, that in a sense her whole body will be dead to the evils and be alive in the Holy Spirit as we bring her up in this way that is not a human way of thinking, but a way of thinking of the Spirit. But we need to be persistent in this way of the Spirit. We need to be persistent in this way of prayer. Prayer is so important. And especially lately, I've been renewing my own prayer life, and I've been renewing some of the miracles that I've witnessed in my own life. I've been reading this book that was given to me by one of our wardens, a book that I think will order many copies and perhaps have a study on this book. And it's a book about a group of ladies, a group of sisters in Germany right after the war. And Germany right after the war had nothing but rubble. And yet these sisters had this small plot of land, and they realized they had to serve the community with what they had. And time after time they would struggle and they would pray, and the Lord would provide for them. They would provide one building and then another and another and another. And every time their back was up against the wall, just like the Jews when they were about to go over the sea, things would be provided to them in a specific, particular way. And often when they had prayed for something specific, there's a beautiful story where they realized they had to go out and bring in the children from all over the towns. But to do this, they needed a bus. And so the sister came in, she drew a picture of a bus. And in her mind, in her vision, it wasn't just any bus, it was a bright blue bus. Wouldn't any of you want to ride on a bright blue bus to come to church? Well, they prayed and they prayed, and on the last day, when they had almost given up hope, a man showed up and said, "I have this bus." And they said, "Is it a green bus? Is it an old green bus from the army days?" And he says, "No, it's that bright blue one over there." And they all rejoiced because their prayers had been answered. Not only did they receive a bus, but they received the bright blue bus that they really had hoped for. And in so many other things. And I saw the same thing when I worked with Welcome Home Mission, that we had a small piece of property, and we were so confined and we were so busy that we needed more property. And we looked at different things, and we had certain roadblocks, and all of a sudden we found this huge building for a good price, but it was a mess. Well, if you walk by that same building today that we paid $700,000 for, it's worth $5 million today. It has 50 housing units. It has a dental clinic. It has the biggest food warehouse. It has offices. It has warehousing. It's amazing. And everything was provided by the grace of God for Welcome Home Mission because of prayer. As I was chairman of the board, we would sit around the boardroom table and we would pray specifically for things. Today I want you to pray specifically, especially on this day of baptism, where this church is full of children. I want you to continue to pray for those who have been baptized recently, in the past 2.5 years that Joyce and I have been here. Pray for Lance, for Sean, for Caden, for Soren, for Eric, Nika and Samantha Rose, Allison, Lake, Charlotte, Emmy, and in 2 weeks, Farrah. These wonderful little children who need to hear the word of God, to be able to play in the house of God, to play in the water of Jesus Christ. But more than that, pray for this footprint as we continue to build the house of God. Our readings today, I changed it from Hosea. I like Hosea chapter verse 2, where it says, "Yet the number of the people of Israel shall be like the sand of the sea, which can be neither measured nor numbered. And in the place where it was once said, you are not my people, it shall be said, you are the children of the living God. How many times do we hear that our churches are closing down when this church is actually growing and becoming stronger and we're going through renovation? Even in Amos, it talks about, on that day I will raise up the booth of David that has fallen, the church, the temple of David, and repair its breaches and raise up its ruins. This church, this building has been undergoing massive renovations and there's more to come. It says, I will restore the fortunes of my people Israel, and they shall rebuild the ruined cities and inhabit them. But if we just pray about this building, are we cutting ourselves short? When we prayed for Welcome Hall Mission, when we took over that new building, we also prayed for the surrounding area. And lo and behold, there was a sixplex across the street that we bought. And we turned it into 32 apartments. And then we found a parking lot and we turned that into more apartments. And then we bought another building that has a whole food processing department in it that we bought the first floor and we rented out the second floor. And now we bought grocery stores. Can we not enlarge our own footprint? With this reading, when I read it and it talks about to raise up the ruins, I ask you to turn into your hymnals and look at the picture on the back page. What is that picture of? That is the picture of the original Anglican Church. That is the picture where Walter and Iris LeDuc and many of our parents and grandparents came and worshiped God and sang in choirs. That temple of God is now in ruins. Now this is a bit of a far cry because it's already been designated. And I would ask you to be very careful about this because it's not a time to spread rumors that Brian wants to take over the old temple. But I want God to have his will. And for God to have his will, we need to pray for God's will here in this sanctuary today. We need to pray that if God's intent is for that building to be taken back by St. Barnabas, working collectively with the people who perhaps even own it today. But can that temple not be given back to God rather than to the people and things of this world? Colossians speaks to us about moving away from a human way of thinking and thinking in the Spirit. If we read this book of the sisters in Germany who transformed a footprint into a huge place of worship and care for many people with buses and kitchens and hostels, what can we do here? This building is almost full with all of the things that are happening. We will soon need more space. So I ask you to take this home and pray about it in quiet and in private. Do not start a rumor mill, but see what the Lord says to you as we pray for this building, for this footprint, but more, for all the children we're praying this for, the children that are here today, the children that are not yet even born, the children who have been baptized and yet have no place to go. This will be the heritage of St. Barnabas, this footprint, this place. With God, nothing is impossible. So I sincerely, sincerely ask you to pray that God truly shows us his will for this place and this footprint here in St. Michael. Amen.
Amy, come on and bring your family.
Yes, and all children are welcome to come and gather around the baptismal font here today. We gather to welcome little Emmy into the sanctuary, this place of worship, and to this community of St. Bartholomew here today. The parents and sponsors will now present Emmy for holy baptism, and they say, will you be responsible for seeing that this child is presented today is nurtured in the faith and life of the Christian community?
I will, with God's help.
Will you, by your prayers and witness, help this child to grow into the full stature of Christ?
I will, with God's help.
And do you affirm your renunciation of evil?
I renounce.
You renounce the evil powers of this world which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce all sinful desires to draw you from the love of God?
I renounce.
And do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior?
I do.
And do you put your whole trust in his grace and love?
I do.
And do you promise to obey him as your Lord?
I do.
And now, to everybody who is here, will you who witness these vows do with all your power to support any in your life in Christ?
We will.
Did I hear that in the back row too?
Yeah. Let us now pray for Emmy, who is receiving the sacrament of the word. And we will repeat saying, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O Lord, from the way we sin and death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill her with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
Teach Emmy to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send her into the world a witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring Emmy to the fullness of your peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized into the life of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of his resurrection and look for him to come again in glory, who lives and reigns now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. We thank you, God, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over water, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through water, you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt into the land of promise. In water, your Son, Jesus Christ, received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, the leader. Through his death and resurrection, and from the bondage of sin into everlasting life, we thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it, we are buried with Christ in his death. By it, we share in his resurrection. Through it, we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we bring into his fellowship those who come to him in faith, baptizing you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Now sanctify this water by the power of the Holy Spirit, to those who are here cleansed from sin and born again, may continue forever the risen life of Jesus Christ our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be all honor and glory, now and forever.
Amen.
And now let us join with Emmy, who is being committed to Christ,
Christ, and renew our home by the heavenly covenant. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He descended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in God, the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
And will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, and the breaking of bread, and the hymn of prayer?
I will, God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you follow this day, repent and serve the Lord? Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will.
And will you strive to safeguard the integrity of God's creation, respect, sustain, and renew the life of the earth?
Celebration, continuation of that celebration. And as they say, and many more. And now for our offertory hymn, All People That on Earth Do Dwell. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh of the Virgin Mary and shared our human nature. He lived and died as one of us to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. In fulfillment of your will, he stretched out his hands in suffering
to bring release to those who place their hope in you. And so we want for you a holy people. He chose to bear our griefs and sorrows, and to give up his life on the cross, that he might shatter the chains of evil and death, and banish the darkness of sin and despair. And by his resurrection, he brings us into the light of your presence. And now, with all creation, we raise our voices to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy,
holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You may be seated. Holy and gracious God, accept our praise for your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who on the night that he was handed over to suffering and death, took bread and gave thanks to you, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is broken for you." And in the same way, Jesus took the cup, saying, "This is my blood, which is shed for you. When you do this, you do it in memory of me." Remembering, therefore, his death and resurrection, we offer you this bread and this cup, giving thanks that you have made us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. We ask you to send your Holy Spirit upon the offering of your church. Gather into one all who share in these sacred mysteries, filling them with the Holy Spirit and confirming their faith in the truth, that together we may praise you and give you glory through your servant Jesus Christ. All glory and honor are yours, Father and Son, with the Holy Spirit, in the Holy Church, now and forever. Amen. And now, rejoicing in the presence of God, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
We be many of one body, for we all share in one body.
The gifts of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Here at St. Barnabas, we share an open table. Joyce and I will consume the bread and the wine, and then I will come around with just the hosts, which are individually wrapped in plastic. Those of you who wish to take communion, hold out your hands, and I will place this in your hand. You can partake of it now, or I would suggest that you take it home after you've washed your hands, and then partake in at that time. We're still cognizant of COVID, so we're taking every precaution still at this time.
Thank you.
Father in heaven, strengthen the unity of your church so that we who have been fed with the holy things may fulfill your will in the world. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation in the church in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen. And may the light of our risen Lord open your minds to see through understanding the scriptures. And may the light of Christ forever shine upon you and keep peace within you. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be and remain with you always. Amen. And now, our closing hymn, we praise you, Lord, for the Jesus Christ baptism, number 47.
Rejoicing in the power of the Spirit.
Amen.